people just say, oh, you're crazy. Like, how many kilometers did you run this morning? And how many hours did you train this week? My name is Valerie. I started sports as a very healthy, you know, thing. I wanted to lose weight. And then progressively, you add more and more and you realize it's actually an addiction.
Exercise inherently, we know, is good for us. So it is hard for us to think about it as an addiction, but it comes under an umbrella term of behavioral addiction. Recreational exercise adds to your life, whereas the addiction takes away from your life. People don't come to a clinic saying, I think I've got exercise addiction. They'll often come with a relationship breakdown, anxiety, depression, work problems. And then as you unpick all of that and unpack it, you'll actually find that exercise is the culprit. It's not extremely common, but I think it's becoming so.
You want to control every aspect of your life, and control can quickly become an obsession. And when then other things add on to your life, which are out of your control, it can be relationships, your family, anything, that's when everything collapses. And I went through then depression, burnout, and to be off work.
I think it's the buzz you get from it. It's the endorphins, all those feel-good factors. They get addicted to that feel-good factor. Some people get too competitive. And they get addicted to the exercise because they think it's going to make them a better competitor. I think apps, social media, there are some make it too competitive and people don't go out and enjoy what they're doing. It's not just about tracking what you're doing, it's about competing against the next person. And it's not always a good thing.
It's all about letting go, not being obsessed with it. It's learning to not control everything. Learning to not be perfect.